Hello my dear friends, I hope you're doing super duper wonderful, and in today's video you will learn how you can create this impressive looping animation in PowerPoint. So, let's go! Okay my dear friends, so let me show you how you can create this standing animation in PowerPoint as well. And let's start with this empty slide. And first of all, let's find a beautiful photo that we could use as our slide background. And now let me just copy this photo from my previous slide. And by the way, this photo comes from unsplash.com. Link is in the video description if you'd like to use it as well. So let's make sure that we copy this photo and let's paste it into our slide. That's beautiful. And next, my friends, let me show you how we can create those pointy arrows that will be moving across the road. And the best thing is that we can design these arrows just by using PowerPoint. And first of all, let's make sure we turn on these slide guides so that we can see where is the center of the slide. This way it will be much easier to design those arrows. And now let's go to Insert, Shapes, and let's look for a triangle tool. Here it is. And let's hold down the Shift key to draw a perfect triangle, just like that. Let's make it orange so that we can better see it. And now let's flip it to the left side, okay. And let's make sure it nicely touches the middle of the slide. And next we can grab this yellow handle and let's move it to the bottom, just like that. And after that, let's just right click on the triangle, let's go to edit points, and now we can move this point even lower, like this. That's nice. And now let's just select this triangle and let's squish it down a bit, just like that, okay. And now we can duplicate this shape, so let's just hit Ctrl D to do that. And now for this copy, let's flip it horizontally, so basically this way we have created the right side of our arrow shape. So now let's make sure that both of these guys are perfectly aligned. Let's select both of them, let's go to Shape Format, Merge Shapes, and let's choose Union. And this way both of these shapes become one solid shape. That's beautiful. And next my friends, we can turn off those slide guides, we don't have to use them anymore. Let's uncheck Guides, and let's jump into Shape Format and let's add white outlines to this shape. So let's go to Shape Outline, let's choose white, and that's looking beautiful. And instead of this orange, let's jump into Format Shape, let's go into Fill Options, and let's add a gradient fill, okay? So let's say that your gradient looks something like this, where you have four color stops. So let's actually use just two color stops, so we can remove these middle ones. And on one side, let's say that we have a solid white, and on the other side, we have a solid black, okay? Let's bring them closer together so that we can see the gradient better, okay? And now let's pick a preset where the white color is at the top and black color is at the bottom. So let's just find the correct preset, and I think this is the one, okay? So white is at the top and black is at the bottom. And now let's select this black color stop and let's actually turn it white. But for the transparency, let's crank it up to 100%, so this way it becomes fully transparent. And now we can adjust the positions of these color stops. So for the right one, let's use 80%. And for the left one, let's use 20%. Of course, you can use any positioning that you wish. And for the line, let's make sure we have a solid line. And for the width, I'm using 3 points. And next, my friends, let's grab the arrow shape and let's move it below the slide. Let's make it a bit wider. And let's make sure that the angle of the arrow is matching the angle of the road. This way, everything is going to be looking beautiful. And we can turn on the slide guides to check if the arrow is sitting in the middle of the slide. It's looking beautiful. And next, my friends, let's animate this arrow shape. Let's make sure it goes up. And to make that happen, let's add a motion pathline animation. So here it is. Let's click on it and we get two bubbles, a green one and a red one. So let's grab that red bubble and let's move it upwards. This is going to be the ending position of our motion pathline animation. That's beautiful. And now let's make sure that we can see the animation pane. In the animation pane, we can see all of the animations that we have added. That's beautiful. Let's make sure that for the duration we use, for example, 4 seconds, and this is how the animation is looking so far. And currently, as you can see, this arrow shape is just moving upwards. And if we would double click the motion pathline animation, we would jump into its animation options. We have 2 seconds of smooth start and smooth end. That's beautiful. Let's leave it the way it is. But what's more important is how to actually make sure that this arrow shrinks while it's going up. And for this reason, let's add a second animation. This is going to be an exit animation, which is called a basic zoom animation. All right. So as you can see, a second animation has been added. Let's make sure it starts with previous, with the previous animation. Let's use the same duration, 4 seconds. And now this arrow shape should be going up and shrinking or zooming out at the same time. And this way we have achieved the result that we want. Let's check it out on the full screen. That's easy peasy, lemon squeezy. And by the way, if you'd like to master PowerPoint animations, then I would definitely recommend checking out the PowerPoint Animation Mastery course on pptskill.com, where I'll teach you all of the animation secrets step by step until you become a PowerPoint animation pro. And by the way, you can save $100 with coupon OneSkill100. So make sure you insert the coupon during checkout to get the discount. And now let's continue with the tutorial. Okay, my dear friends, and next let's make sure we duplicate this arrow 3 more times so that we have 4 arrows in total. That's beautiful. And now in the animation pane, let's select all of these animations and let's make sure all of them start with previous. That's nice. And now for these two animations, let's add a delay of 1 second. For these two animations, let's add a delay of 2 seconds. And for the last two animations, let's add a delay of 3 seconds. And this way we have basically added 1 second delay between all of the arrows. And now let's just make sure that all of these guys are sitting on top of each other, so we can select all of the arrows and let's align them to the center and to the middle so that they are perfectly in the same spot. Let's move them to the center of the slide. That's nice. And let's check it out on the full screen. So once I click once to launch the animations, we get the first arrow, then the second, then the third, and then the last, the fourth arrow. But as you can see, all of these animations played just a single time, and let's say I would like to loop them. So let's select them all in the animation pane. Let's go to animation options. Let's go into the timing tab. And for the repetition, let's choose until the end of slide. And now as you can see, once I expand the animation pane, all of these animation bars seem to be infinite because they are. They will be looping. So let's check it out on the full screen. Let's click once. And now as you can see, all of these 4 arrows are just looping infinitely. And that's super duper awesome. And next, my friends, let me show you how we can create that beautiful slide title here at the top of the slide, somewhere right here. And for that, let's just jump into the Insert tab. Let's click on the text box tool. Let's click once. And now we can type in anything that we wish. For example, let's go. Okay, let's increase the font size to something huge. For example, 90 points. Okay, let's change the font color to white. And for the font, I'm using this beautiful font called Hanson. Link is in the video description. Let's make sure that the text is centered aligned. That's beautiful. And now let's open up the paragraph settings so that we can adjust the spacing between the lines. And I'm choosing multiple 0.7 and I'm just hitting OK and skadoosh. Now we get that beautiful narrow gap between the lines. That's awesome. And now let's hit Ctrl D to make a duplicate text box. And let's select the first text box and let's jump into the text options. Let's go to text outline and let's add a solid outline. And for the outline color, let's just use the eyedropper tool to copy this dark green color. And for the width, let's use, for example, 10 points. And now as you can see, the first text box has a thick line around its letters. And let's make sure we select both of the text boxes and let's align them to the center and to the middle so that they're perfectly sitting on top of each other. And this way we have a nice text box with some nice outlines. And the thing with text outlines in PowerPoint is that they're growing both inside and outside. And if you'd like to see your text outlines only on the outside, you have to basically duplicate the text box as we did here and place it on top. And now in the selection pane, let me call the first text box white, and the second text box outline. And now let's make sure that the text box outline is selected and let's jump into the text shadow options and let's choose this preset, okay, where we can see the shadow on the right edge. Let's drop down the transparency to 0. Let's make sure there's no blur. Let's increase the distance, okay. And this way we have basically created a 3D look to our letters. That's nice. And now let's select our text box white, which is the top text box, okay. And for this guy, let's add an inside text shadow, okay, but instead of a black dark color, let's use this preset. As you can see now, it looks muddy. Instead of black dark color, let's use the eyedropper tool and let's, for example, pick this orangey color. And this way we have added a nice warm glow to our slide title, and you can, of course, play with the blur slider to get the look that you like. Okay, my friends, so let's check it out on the full screen once again. So now we have our beautiful slide title and we get those beautiful shrinking looping arrows at the bottom. And to make it even more fun, let's animate the slide title as well. And first of all, let's make sure that we select both of the text boxes and let's group them into a single group. This way it will be much easier to add animations to both of them. As you can see in the selection pane, both of the text boxes are in a single group. That's nice. And now let's just move these text boxes outside of the slide. We can increase the font size as well. And now let's select this arrow which already has animations, and let's use the animation painter to paste the same animations to our slide title. Okay. And now let's just adjust the ending position of the motion path animation. Let's just drag this bubble to somewhere right here, just above the road. And let's make sure that in the animation pane, we grab these two last animations, which are the animations of our slide title. And let's move them below the first two animations, which are the animations of the first arrow. And for the slide title animation duration, I'm using 8 seconds. And this way, the slide title will be traveling at a slower speed than the arrows. So all of the arrows are traveling at the speed of 4 seconds, and the slide title is moving at the speed of 8 seconds. And to make it even more fun, let's duplicate the slide title so that we have 2 slide titles, okay. And now in the selection pane, let's just grab these 2 animations and let's move them below the animations of the first slide title. And let's just add a 4 second delay, okay. And let's just make sure that both of these groups of text boxes are perfectly aligned on top of each other. Okay, and let's check it out once again. So now we should see the first slide title, and after 4 second delay, we should see the second one. And since all of the animations are set to repeat until the end of slide, they'll just keep on looping infinitely. That's super duper awesome. Congratulations, my friends! Now you know how you can create this stunning looping animation in PowerPoint. And if you would like to take your looping PowerPoint animations to the next level, then definitely check out this video next. I'll see you there.